points out of the playoffs right now. Good evening, everyone, and welcome into Steel Hall for another hockey night in Fredonia. As you are listening to Fredonia Radio 88.9 FM, WCVF, and WDVL 89.5. I'm Kevin Syracuse with Steve Staversky, right?
Staversky, yeah.
Okay. Steve, how's it going?
Going pretty well. Gotta say, this is better than going to class right now. So just enjoy some hockey, and hopefully our Blue Devils here can pull out a victory. They had a heart-racing game last week against
Buff State.
Against Buff State, thank you. Down 3 goals with a few minutes left, and they were able to pot a few in and took it to a tie. So hopefully they're a little easier on our hearts this one, but still expect a very hard-fought game down to the bitter finish.
Well, Fredonia is 4-9-6 overall, 1-7-2 in Suniak play. They only have 4 points, and Morrisville has 10 points, so 6 points behind with 6 games remaining. So a big one here tonight. As here we go, Jasper Corrigan Barley comes in and takes a shot, and it gets blocked, goes into the corner. Hugo Gamache goes after it. Work it back around the net. And the Cardinals recover. Just underway here in Steel Hall. As Tracy tries slinging it back, and the Cardinals steal this and come away with some good numbers here, and that shot was saved by Anton Rosen, the senior goaltender who is playing tonight after Steve, was he in net last week?
He was not. Pascarello was in net.
Okay, yeah, so I believe this is Rosen's first game back. He had a few concussions over the last couple months. So the Blue Devils get back their starting netminder tonight as he makes a pad save here. And a wraparound chance saved by Rosen. Blue Devils come up with it. This is, well, it just went over the stick of number 16, Greg Lee.
Josh, the one who knows all.
Now Max Blitz keeps it in. Out in front of the net, and Ryan Dunner was unable to connect there. Cardinals come into the Blue Devils zone. That shot is deflected wide of the net. Ethan Kerbis taps it up to Dunner. Now Craig McCabe, shot from center ice, right on number 29, Jimmy Poreda, the junior netminder for the Cardinals. Matt Lemanski puts on the brakes, now finds number 24, Tyler Ryder. The Cardinals are able to regain possession, and shot is saved by Anton Rosen. That came off the stick of number 24, Brendan Schulte.
Well, it looks like Ryder and Young are getting into it after the play. They don't look to be exchanging numbers.
So, yeah, a little extra curricular activity.
Love to see it.
Tanner Kalu will be in the faceoff circle for the Devils. And he wins that draw. Now Lemanski tries to pass it to Kalu, and it goes over a stick. Manley goes to get it and tries getting it back to center ice. And now the Cardinals dump it right back in. Gamache. His pass is too far, and we're going to have an icing. So pretty even here in the first couple minutes. Plattsburgh, 4 shots, Fredonia 2. Nothing too crazy yet.
Yeah, it's still a road period here for Plattsburgh. They drove at least 8 hours to get here. They're trying to get their bus legs out. Hopefully Fredonia could take advantage.
Cardinals win the draw. Shot saved by Rosen. Hard slap shot there. Puck comes out in front of the net. It's still loose. Who's going to come up with it? The Cardinals do. But Rosen's up on his feet. Arroyo now. Shot deflected just wide, inches wide. And now the Blue Devils work it into the Cardinals zone, but good hit there as Chandler Judd was the victim there. Puck's at center ice now. And McCabe will dump it in right over the net. Jacob Haynes, the leading scorer for the Blue Devils, tries to center it. No one is there. Cardinals take over. Shot gets deflected behind the net. Max Blitz now to Jacob Haynes. He slows it down. Here's McCabe. skates into the zone. Gets it behind the net, still has it. Now out to Johnson, and that shot's blocked. And he puts it in. Jasper Cork on Barley is there for the rebound, and the Blue Devils had to have a 1-0 lead.
Excellent start here by the Blue Devils, getting one on Plattsburgh. They got a nice point shot there by Johnson, and they were able to crash the net and bury it. Excellent work by Cork and Barley to get loose in front of the net and take that one in.
So the original shot was from the freshman, the 6'5 freshman defender, Anders Johnson, and then Jasper Cork on Barley was there for the cleanup. So the Devils out to an early 1-0 lead. We're going to have a quick icing here. So Fredonia's third shot goes in.
Yeah, the first shift after the first goal of the game is the most important of the game. Here you can either sustain your pressure or give it back to the opponents.
Faceoff is won by Plattsburgh. Ethan Kurbis is there. He steals it back. Gets it back behind the net. Battle for the puck. Out to Tommy Martin. Greg Lee put the shot on just a little wide. Jake Sutton now recovers for Plattsburgh. Cardinals turnover, and the Blue Devils turn it over once again. So back-to-back turnovers here. Rosen uses his stick to knock that one down. It comes back out, blocked by Demakopoulos, and Whitman tried getting that to Demakopoulos just a little too far. Now the puck goes behind the net. Broken stick behind the play here. That was Demakopoulos. The Cardinals have it in the Fredonia zone. Centering pass gets deflected, stolen by Chandler Judd. Cardinals have it at center ice and dump it into the Fredonia zone here. Manley gets it behind the net, now swings it back to Kalu. Now up to Ryder. And he gives it back to Hugo Gamache. Lomanski drills it in to the corner as the Blue Devils are gonna get a quick change here. Rosen plays it behind the net. Now this is Tyler Ryder, and he gets it out to center ice, where this is number 17, Christian Thomas. As the Cardinals have it, back out to the point, shot wide of the net. And now Andrew Pizzo, his shot gets blocked. Cork on Barley tries to get it out, and yep, looks like he got it out just enough as yep. Plattsburgh drilled it back in, but
yep, the linesman definitely thought it went out, but must have been just by a hair, so they call an offside. Fredonia's able to regroup. Plattsburgh's been taking it to him the last couple of minutes. Face off just outside their blue line.
Dumped into the Plattsburgh zone. Now the Blue Devils have it behind their net here. Mitchell Hale has it for the Cardinals. His shot gets blocked, but we're going to have a penalty. It looks like I didn't see that. It happened in the background, but a Cardinal is still down behind the net. So I think a big hit there.
Very interesting to see what the call is coming out of this. Sometimes when you got a player down, it goes from a 2-minute boarding to a 5-minute major. So we'll see what the refs call here.
Well, that will be on Ethan Kurbis. So 13:40 left here in the first. Fredonia with a 1-0 lead.
And they are going to the penalty kill. Last week against Buff State, they were constantly on the penalty kill, and it really hurt them throughout the game. They have an excellent penalty kill, but they need to stay out of the box to be successful in this one. Let's see how their first kill of the game goes. And it is, in fact, a 5-minute major. So Kurbis is done for the night as he leaves the ice. So Plattsburgh's got an excellent opportunity here to tie it up and even get some more. If they score on this 5-minute at any time, the penalty does not go down whatsoever.
So, yep, there's the official call. 5-minute misconduct, hit to the head, and a game misconduct. So that's a big blow to the Blue Devils, as Kurbis is one of their leading scorers with 3 goals and 13 assists on the year.
Yeah, Kurbis had a 4-assist night last week at home. That is a huge loss.
Actually, wasn't
for this
it 5
team.
Assists?
It was either 4 or 5.
I think he had an assist on all 5 goals. So a 5-minute penalty here, as the Cardinals get it into the Fredonia zone, battle for it out in the corner, and the Blue Devils are able to drill it back down the ice. And the Cardinals take over once again. Get it into the zone, but the Blue Devils are there, as I believe that was Manley who sent it right back down the ice. Seconds gone in this 5-minute major. Puck goes behind the net, as the Blue Devils are able to clear it again. That was Greg Lee.
Yeah, watch for this Blue Devil penalty kill to be very aggressive. They don't like to give up any time and space.
Cardinals have it down in the corner once again. And Letmanski clears it. So a couple nice clears here for Fredonia. Minute and a half gone. A little over 12 minutes remaining in the period. Cardinals work it in. Another battle in the corner. Cardinals haven't been able to get anything set up here. And once again, the puck comes out to center ice. And we're going to have an offsides. So really nice defense here from Fredonia. Almost 2 minutes gone in the major. And Plattsburgh hasn't been able to generate anything.
Yep, Fredonia needs to keep up the pressure. They're really not giving up anything to this Plattsburgh power play, and they're going to need to continue it for the next 3 minutes and get out of this. This is a key part of the game.
Blue Devils win the faceoff and send it right back down the ice. Under 3 minutes remaining in the major. Cardinals come in with speed. This is number 21, Adam Tredowitz. Now number 15, Austin Anselmo. Cardinals finally have something set up here. Anselmo down to number 13, Cullen Kane. Back out to the point. Petrikevich back to Anselmo. His shot gets deflected.
Excellent block there by Ryder, who went on all fours to block that one. And it skies out and goes into the mesh. Way to lay out for your team there, Ryder.
So 2:35 remaining in this major to Ethan Kurbis. Blue Devils win another faceoff and drill it right back down, as number 21, Adam Tredowitz, will recover for the Cardinals. Now into the Blue Devils zone, Jacob Haynes gets it and clears it once again. So almost 3 minutes gone, and just about, I believe, 2 shots generated by the Cardinals.
Yeah, only one real big chance, and that got blocked by Ryder.
Now they have it on the wing here. Kalou finishes his check, and Tommy Martin, the junior captain, clears it. Under 2 minutes remaining. 10.5 in the period. Cardinals send it in, but it's going to be an icing. So the Cardinals really aren't able to generate anything here on this 5-minute advantage.
Yikes. This is where having a power play for so long can actually work against you. Because at this point, they're not in sync. Their power play's not working, and it can't just end so they get back on 5-on-5. They're losing the momentum. They're starting to get frustrated.
Cardinals win the draw. This is number 16, Ryan Kuhn. He falls down.
Watch out for the blue line.
Kuhn has it at center ice. He comes into the zone. And Blue Devils steal it right back and send it in behind Pareda.
Good hit by Kuhn there right along the boards to stop the advance by Plattsburgh.
Ryder steals it. He's waiting for someone to come in, and McCabe just sends it right back down. Just about 4 minutes gone now. Here's number 39, Liam Lawson. See if he can get anything going. Battle for it in behind the net. And still a battle as the refs decide to blow the whistle.
Yeah, I don't think they want anyone speared down behind the net. So they blew the puck dead, and their faceoff's going to be to Rosen's right coming up. Excellent penalty kill so far. They're not quite out of the woods yet, but they're getting there. 51 seconds, and they're in the clear.
Corgan Barley wins a faceoff, and it actually hit Rosen. But the Blue Devils send it down the ice nonetheless. 40 seconds left in the Curvis Major. Arroyo. And that pass got into Christian Thomas, but another offsides.
Yeah, tough start here by Plattsburgh. They were getting some momentum. They drew the penalty, and now they are just struggling to put anything resembling an offensive pressure situation on this power play.
As the Blue Devils send it back down the ice, right on Pareda.
It's almost like we should just have that recorded and keep playing it over and over.
Sound like a broken record. And they get it at center ice and drill it back down the ice.
Who would have thought?
10 seconds left in the major. Arroyo tries to get something going here as he has it out of the point. And that shot, broken stick there. Andrew Pizzo broke his stick. Goes behind the net, and Pareda will play it, and that will do it for the 5-minute major. So Fredonia able to kill it. Puck gets worked out to center ice. This is Cullen Kane. And that pass got deflected. Charlie Manley now. Works it back along the boards. Cardinals cleared in front of the net, but no one's there. And now Tracy tries to get it out, but number 12, Christian Dahl, is there to keep it in. Gamache. Has it to the left of Rosen. Swings it back. And the Blue Devils will clear it. Dahl goes after it as we get a big change here for Fredonia. McCabe up to Whitman. He jams it in as it goes out to the point now. And here comes Kane. He's in one-on-one here. But great defense from Craig McCabe. He finishes his check, forces a turnover, and now gets it out to center ice.
McCabe with a textbook hip check there to completely take away the offensive scoring chance.
Cardinals get it down behind Rosen, but the Blue Devils are there. This is number 4, Philip Middleton, graduate student, defenseman. Puck gets swung back along the boards in front of the Fredonia bench. And now it's going to slide all the way down to the Cardinals zone. Falanja gets it in. And Arroyo finds Middleton. Gets around Lemanski, puts up the shot, wide of the net. Cardinals are able to keep it in the zone. This is Arroyo. Now over to Middleton. Back to Arroyo. Now to Kuhn. His shot gets blocked. And the Cardinals keep it in. Here's Arroyo. He's out at the point. To Middleton. Shot wide of the net. And now it goes into the corner. As Haynes goes after it, and the Cardinals are able to keep it in momentarily. Now Haynes comes away with it. Up to Lemanski. Now to Haynes. And his shot is blocked by Pareda. So Haynes came in one on two. Good attack there from Fredonia.
Excellent seam pass by Lemanski there.
Or not even Fredonia, good attack by Haynes. And now Victor Tracy loses his footing, but is back on his feet. But we're going to have an offsides.
Yeah, Demikopoulos was just a tad bit offside. I don't know, kind of looked like he dragged it, but Lions got a better view than I do.
5:32 remaining in the first period. Fredonia with a 1-0 lead. Six shots on goal for the Blue Devils, five for the Cardinals.
Which is impressive considering they had a five-minute penalty kill.
Yeah, so they only have five shots on goal in the period with a five-minute major. And they, generated two or three shots at the most?
At most. A lot of blocks, a lot of clears.
Hugo Gamache sends it in behind the Cardinals' net. As number 15, Austin Anselmo, has it.
Yep, looks like Fredonia is going back to the penalty kill.
Yep.
It's going to be a tripping penalty on Ryan Dunner. Got tied up with someone in the corner. They went down, he did not, so he gets the call. So Fredonia's going back to the kill. They had a lot of success on it, but they don't want to burn out their killers before the end of the game. It is still only the first period.
I'm going to see if I can find the team stats. I want to see their special teams. As the Cardinals win the faceoff, get it in behind the net. Still have it behind the net with Hale. Now back out to Arroyo, over to Pizzo. Now to Thomas, his shot gets blocked by Max Blitz. Blue Devils send it back down the ice. And Pareda plays it along the boards, and Thomas gets it in right away. And almost offsides. Fredonia has it now. Judd uses the boards, banks it in. Lemanski goes after it. 45 seconds gone in this penalty. He gets it out by the net and puts on a backhand shot, but Pareda is there to cover up.
Yeah, big turnover there by Liam Lawson. Puck kind of just squirted past him, and Lemanski was there to jump on the turnover. Fortunately, their goaltender, Pareda, was right there, square to the shot, and Lemanski had nowhere to go with it. But once again, Fredonia, hard, very aggressive on this PK, and it is quite successful so far.
Cardinals win the faceoff here. Now get it up to number 9, Hunter Alden. In behind the net, behind Rosen. And Kuhn tries to get it back out to the point, and the Blue Devils deflect it out of play. 54 seconds left in this Dunner penalty, and 3:59 left in the first. Fredonia with a 1-0 lead here on Fredonia Radio. Cardinals win the faceoff. Kuhn. Back out to Dahl. Into the corner with Kuhn. And his pass gets stolen. Blue Devils try to get it out, but Cardinals keep it in. Fire it right back, and Rosen is there to save that wrist shot. Coming off of the stick of Brendan Schulte.
Yeah, Plattsburgh didn't have anyone in front there. It's just a nice little floater right to the breadbasket. No chance on that one. Rosen squared to the shot. Weiser's going to have to create something on these power plays if they want to score. Fredonia's not giving them an inch.
So just one shot generated here from the Cardinals as this shot gets blocked by the Blue Devils and out to center ice as Kalu fights with Arroyo, and we're going to have another whistle here. Is that offsides?
It is offsides.
So that's another thing about the Cardinals here. That a lot of times they're not even able to get on sides here, let alone get shots on net.
Well, they are a young team. Their top two scorers are seniors, but everyone else is pretty much freshmen and sophomores. Plattsburgh's usually a powerhouse in the SUNY Act, but it looks like they've got a bit of a development year under their belt.
They win the faceoff here and get it in behind the Fredonia net. This is McCartney now. His shot kicked away by Rosen. And that will do it for the Dunner penalty. Arroyo now gets blasted from behind from Victor Tracy. And I think, yep, they're going to call Tracy on the penalty there.
Yep, when you see numbers, you can't attack that way. You can still be physical, but you got to go through the hands, got to go through the stick, and he went right through his back. So it looks like it's going to be a checking from behind. Not sure what the official call is, but it's going to be 2 minutes. And once again, Fredonia back on the penalty kill. And is that Tracy?
Yeah, so that was Victor Tracy. We'll see.
He is not happy in the box. I know that feeling.
We'll see what the official call is. So 3 minutes left in the period. Checking from behind was a call. So 3 minutes left in the period, two obviously on this penalty now. So assuming they kill it here, the Blue Devils will have 1 minute of five on five in this period.
Yeah, knock on wood though.
Yeah. Arroyo. That was shot by Tredowitz.
Dangerous chance there for Plattsburgh, but Fredonia's able to clear, and that's why we knock on wood.
Arroyo uses the boards to get it in, and Hale just swings it right back around to Arroyo. He tries to dump it down low, but Gamache is there to get it back to center ice. Pizzo recovers, skates all the way behind Pareda as the Cardinals reset here. Long pass is successful to Draben, their leading scorer. Now back to Arroyo, and his slap shot is saved by Rosen. So the Cardinals are able to generate some more shots here. I hope I didn't jinx the Blue Devils.
Yeah, easy there, Kev. But, Gamache and Hale mixing it up in front of the net. Just getting acquainted. We're just getting started here.
So 59 seconds left in the penalty, a minute 58 in the period. Cardinals win the draw, but that puck squeezes out into center ice, where Dahl has it for Plattsburgh. Over to Schulte. Now up to Kuhn. In over the line. Taken down by Lee. Kalu gets it. Swings it over to Martin, and he will clear it. 30 seconds left on this third power play for the Cardinals here in what is going on the ninth minute of a one-man advantage. They get it in over the line here. Here's Kuhn on the wing, back out to Schulte. Now to Middleton. Now back out to Schulte. His shot gets blocked. 5 seconds left. And the Blue Devils don't clear it as they have killed off yet again another penalty. And just a little too far off the stick of Antonio Dimakopoulos. 50 seconds left in the period. Whitman keeps it in. Middleton retrieves it behind his net. Whitman finishes his check. Cardinals come up with number 20, Brendan Young. But nothing's going there, as Max Blitz now has it. And he'll just flip it over the defenders for the Cardinals. And Arroyo will start things for Plattsburgh. in over the line. And good chance there from the Cardinals, but puck just didn't bounce their way. But now Brendan Young has it. Tracy finishes his check. Are they going to call for another penalty here?
No. They blew it dead because lost his helmet. But excellent hit there by Tracy. Young tried to make a move, and he got dropped.
Okay, so is that a rule that the helmet comes off, that's automatically blown dead then? Okay.
Yeah, that's an NCAA rule. It's for safety purposes.
Did they do that in the NHL? Or?
NHL, no.
Okay.
They don't care as much.
So Tracy is still on the ice. So 5-on-5 for 5 seconds left. Actually, it was 5-on-4. Now number 15, Austin Anselmo, will skate out for the last 5 seconds. Cork on Barley wins a draw, sends it down in behind Pareda, and that will do it for the first period as the Blue Devils have a 1-0 lead, even though they were down a man for 9 minutes. So almost half of that period, they were playing 5-on-4 hockey, or in their case, 4-on-5. And, just great job by the penalty, or by the special teams. And they skate into the locker room with a 1-0 lead.
Yep, playing with fire, but they're out of it with a 1-0 lead. Now we'll play some music for you, and we'll be back with your intermission report. You ain't got a one-track mind, yeah. Have it any way you like, yeah. And I can tell that you know I know how I want it. Ain't nobody else can relate. Boy, I like that you ain't no fake. Baby, lay me down and let's pray. I'm telling you the way I like it, how I want it. Yeah. And I could be all the things you told me not to be. Yeah. When you try to come for me, I keep on flourishing. Yeah. And he's the universe and I'm the company. You love it how I move you. You love it how I touch you, my one. When all is said and done, you will believe God is a woman. And I feel it after midnight. A feeling that you can't fight, my one. It lingers when we're done. You will believe God is a woman. I tell you all the things you should know. You try to come for me, I keep on flourishing. Yeah. And he see the universe when I'm the company. It's me. Yeah. Welcome back, everyone. You are listening to Hockey Night in Fredonia on WDVL.5, The Inferno, and WCBF 88.9, The Voice. I am Steve, and here with me is
Trevor Hauer
with your intermission report. So, Trevor, you had a great angle on watching that period. What did you see from our Blue Devils?
Well, Steve, we saw a ton of stuff in this game. But the main thing that I saw, for sure, was the fact that this game is super fast-paced. Plattsburgh and Fredonia seem really in control. They like to get pucks in deep. They like to get the shots on goal. And with that, you had Cork and Barley scoring the first goal for Fredonia, which they really, really needed at the 3 minutes and 20-second mark of the first period. From that angle, it looked like a pretty good shot. It's just the fact that they got to keep this going. And if they keep this run going, they can easily cruise for a win here tonight.
Yeah, it was a great shot by freshman defenseman Janssen there. And Cork and Barley got loose in front of the net. I don't know how he got that loose, but
yeah,
he was able to bury the rebound. And, hey, we ain't complaining.
No, any way you can get him is good for Fredonia.
Yeah.
Because, you know, both of these teams, Plattsburgh too, these guys are very hungry for a win, and you can tell. Because sitting at the bottom of the SUNYAC standings, so whoever gets the win here tonight is going to be pretty darn important. And we saw the time on attack tonight was pretty much even, very, very physical. We saw Fredonia, Chandler Judd almost put a Plattsburgh player into our home bench.
Yeah, their guy needed a chiropractor after that one. He was bent over.
Oh, that one.
Yikes.
I would not want to feel that one in the morning.
Felt that one. It hurts.
And
inside
then,
scoop, it hurts to have your back bent over the boards.
That's
shocker.
Definitely a shock, and man, that would hurt. I'm surprised he stayed on the ice after that shift.
But the story of that period has absolutely got to be the penalty kill.
The penalty kill was fantastic.
Yeah, penalty kill was awesome, but they got to stop taking so many penalties. They took a five-minute major on a hit to the head by Kerbis and followed up with a couple of minor penalties, tripping and hit from behind. Fredonia's got to stay disciplined or they're going to burn out their successful PK players, but they can only breathe so much when they're on the ice so much.
Exactly. You want to keep 5-on-5 as much as you can, because sometimes the penalty kill, they won't last in the second and third period as well as it did in the first period. And we know that just watching NHL and even the NCAA D3 games. And, you know, Kerbis is he's a pretty good player.
Yeah, he had four or five assists, forget what it was, last week at home against Buff State. That's a huge loss for these Blue Devils.
And just, he took the penalty with 6:20 into the first period. We don't want to see that. Us as Fredonia announcers, we don't want to see that, because he's a very, very special player to this organization. And once you take that five in a game, you're knocking out one of your best players.
Yep, so it's next man up. You got to look for your Captain Charlie Manley's. You look for your leading scorer, Jacob Haynes, to pick up the slack. Haynesy came in on a semi-breakaway after a great seam pass by Letmanski. And it just showed how well Haynes is, even when he doesn't have space. He's able to create it or even work with the little space he's given. Look for him to break out in this second period if they start playing more 5-on-5.
We definitely are looking for Charlie Manley to start, you know, stepping up in the second and third period. But he did have a nice hit on number 13, Cullen Kane, for the Plattsburgh Cardinals on a great scoring chance. It was a one-on-one play, and Manley stood him up, knocked him down, took the puck away. That's the kind of guy we like to see on the Fredonia Blue Devils.
Yeah, McCabe had the same thing. The Plattsburgh player was in one-on-one against him, a lot of space to work with, and McCabe shut him down and had a classic hip check and just threw him to the ice, just stopped the play dead. And those are the type of plays that can really turn around a game.
Absolutely, absolutely. As long as they can stay physical but stay out of the box and obviously take more shots on goal too. But right now, Fredonia has the 1-0 lead on what should be a really great finish tonight, Steve.
Yeah, you know, pass, shoot, score.
Pass, shoot, score.
Pass,
that's
shoot,
what they
and
say.
Score.
That's what they say. They say dump, chase, pinch, crank as well.
Oh, yeah. You know, you got to get pucks in deep here and, you know, work those corners.
Always. We got to be that, you know, say those coaches' cliches like that. But it really does work.
Hey, they're not cliches. They're classics, okay?
They are classics, yeah.
Exactly.
Definitely agree with you on that one. Hopefully this game stays fast-paced. It's a fun one to watch. And, yeah, it must be even more fun for you calling the game with Kevin.
Yeah, it's pretty fun. You know, I don't know whose bright idea it was to let me on the air. Let me, you know, I like to hear the sound of my voice. I hope you guys like to, too. Our sports director, Josh Schmidt, shout out to him for letting us take over the game and, you know, have some fun with you tonight. You've been listening to the Intermission Report on Hockey Night in Fredonia. You're listening on WDVL 89.5, The Inferno, and WCVF 88.9, The Voice. We'll play some music for you, and we'll be back at you with the second period action. Oh, he's so handsome, what's his name?
Celia Cruz, tengo el azúcar. Tú que va medio y se fue de pecho como Ginny Luca. Te vamos a tumbar la peluca y arranca pa'l carajo, que a ti no te va a pasar la boca. Mi tele y Valenciaga me reciben en la entrada. Pa 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 ra, sí, like I'm Lady Gaga. Y no te me hagas, que en cover de vivo tú has visto mi cara. No salgo de tu mente, donde quiera que viaje, he escuchado mi gente. Ya no soy high, soy como el testa rosa. No soy el que se la vive y también el que la goza. Goza, goza, es la cosa, mami, es la cosa. Goza, el goza, que mira sufre y el que toca goza. Goza, goza, goza.
I said I like it like that.
Welcome back here in Steel Hall as we have Hockey Night in Fredonia on Fredonia Radio. Kevin Syracuse here with Steve Staversky. Blue Devils have a 1-0 lead going into the second period as the officials come back onto the ice. And another team that has a 1-0 lead, the Sabres.
Yeah, who would have thought?
Not
me. You know, they crushed our souls last night, but, you know, we're here where they can't hurt us. And that is a blessing for tonight. We got Blue Devils to root for. Not worried about those boys from Buffalo.
Yep, and then they will be back home on Sunday, right, against Anaheim?
Yep, 3 o'clock game at, what do they call it now, KeyBank Center? Yeah, KeyBank.
Yeah.
I always try to call it First Niagara.
Yeah, I know.
I'm living in the past.
Why can't everything just be like 06, 07? HSBC Arena, we still have Breer, still have Drury, have Miller.
I'd settle for 05, 06, the scary good times. But we digress. But we got a game here in front of us, and it has been a very fast-paced game. Hopefully Fredonia here can stay 5-on-5 so they can get some more sustained pressure on the offense.
Well, if you're just tuning in, yes, so Fredonia had 9 minutes of...
Three penalties for 9 minutes total because they had a 5-minute major and then a couple of minors.
Yes, so 9 minutes they spent in the box. They only generated 7 shots, but that was enough as they have a 1-0 lead. Plattsburgh, in 9 minutes of having a one-man advantage, only got 9 shots overall in that whole period. So this is not the powerhouse team that like we usually see from Plattsburgh.
Yeah, it's a bit of a transition year, but here we go in the second period.
Cardinals win the draw, and the Blue Devils recover right behind their net as Corcon Barley goes after it. Right in front of us here is we're at center ice. Now that was Arroyo, out in front of his net, gets it up to DeFelice. Now he comes on, leaves it for McCartney. His shot saved by Rosen. Rebound goes wide, and now the Blue Devils come in a 2-on-1 here. Haynes, Tracy, slap shot, just a little too high. McCartney now at center ice. His shot, stick saved by Rosen, and he isn't able to cover up. And now Ryder up the boards here, flips it in to himself. But Tredowitz is there to steal it right back. He dumps it in behind the Blue Devils' goal. McCabe goes after it. Fight for the puck. Cardinals come out with it. And now Lubanski steals it away. He flips it in, goes after it. Pareda plays it. Right behind his net. Ryder's there for the steal. Pizzo. Up to McCabe. And we're going to have an offsides here.
Yep, Fredonia tried to dump it back in, but it hit Ryder right in the numbers. So automatic blown dead, and we'll have a draw right in front of the Fredonia bench. It's like DeMacoupolis taking this draw.
He wins a faceoff as Chandler Judd swings it in to the corner. Now goes after to finish his check. Puck comes out to center ice. Here's Thomas to Kuhn. Skates in all alone, and good save there from Rosen. Rebound comes out to DeMacoupolis as he gets checked into the boards right in front of the penalty box. Lawson now. He gets hit from behind. That was a clean hit, though. Now the Cardinals flip it in behind Rosen. Thomas goes after it. Puts on the backhand, and that one is kicked away from Rosen. Puck is behind the net now. DeMacoupolis to Judd. He'll dump it in, and the Blue Devils will have a line change here, all five change. Cardinals wait for something to set up here. This is number 6, Jake Sutton. Tries to use the boards to get it to Young, and that is too far from him, and we'll have an icing.
Yeah, just personal thing. It's one of my favorite plays in hockey when a team like wants to do their changes, they set up behind the net and then proceed to ice the puck. I just find it absolutely hilarious. So we got Fredonia's top line coming out here. Haynes is taking the draw.
And we've seen a lot of icings tonight so far.
We have.
So Haynes on the draw. He wins it. Back out to Manley. He's tied for the lead on the Blue Devils this year with 10 goals, tied with Jacob Haynes for the team lead. Haynes also has 15 assists to have a team-leading 25 points. Now Tracy out of the point. His slap shot just a little too high. Now Manley goes after it. Puck's behind the net. Kuhn over to Schulte. Now up to Young. And he gets it in over the line, and we're going to have an offsides here.
Yeah, tricky part about the second period is when the defensemen are changing and when the when Fredonia's offensemen are changing, they're in the zone. So it creates a lot of offsides opportunities if they're not careful. And that's what happened to Young there. He had guys changing when he was trying to break into the zone.
Blue Devils win the faceoff here. Get it up to Kalou. Little 3-on-3 here as the Blue Devils dump and chase. Now Kane, as a puck dribbles out to center ice, Max Blitz will drill it in. Shot on net, kicked aside by Pareda. Arroyo up to Schulte. He'll come in over the line. Tries to feed it into number 13, Colin Kane. That gets deflected and now stolen by Ryan Dunner. Dunner still has it right at the blue line. And Schulte will fall down as the Cardinals turn it over. Momentarily, though, as Middleton puts on the shot, blocked by Blitz. Now McCabe up to Dunner. Stolen right back. Schulte. His pass is stolen by Martin. Back to Schulte. Now Kane. Stops, spins around. And Chandler Judd will come up with it for the Blue Devils. He has it here. Puck goes into the corner. Judd still working on it. Now to the other corner with Cork on Barley. Sticks go flying in front of the net. Chud goes flying down. And now he gets hit with the puck.
Got a little bit of comedy errors here going.
Whitman turns it over as the Cardinals are able to skate out of the zone with it as they just slide it in and get a line change here. Now Haynes. He comes in over the line. Gets stolen away, but Cork on Barley's there to get it right back. And Selmo gets it out. And after another series of battles, and Selmo has it once again. But now Haynes comes in. He's all alone. And Pareda's there for the stop.
Yeah, excellent play there by Tracy to force the turnover, and then Haynes was the beneficiary. Goes in all alone, tried to get Pareda to bite and then roof it over his glove, but Pareda was able to stay with it. Great save by him, and that could be a key one if Plattsburgh gets some offensive pressure going.
Now Kalou, he wins the draw. Tyler Ryder fights forward in the corner. Cardinals have it behind their own net. Now they work to get it out. But Ryder's there, deflects it. And goes back in behind the net. And here come the Cardinals now. They come out of the zone. This is Sutton. Centering pass. Now it comes back out to Dahl. Now Draben down low. Shot gets blocked and Draben gets it back. Swings it around to the other corner. And deflected just wide of the net. As we're going to have a penalty here.
Yeah, it's going to be a hook. The Plattsburgh player hooked Ryder in the corner. And as soon as it happened, Ryder gave the ref a look, and then the arm went up.
So that will be on number 11, Joe Draben. Once again, he is their leading scorer. He has 4 goals and 11 assists this year. And then Kuhn, Arroyo, and Tredowitz, and Lawson are the other top scorers behind him.
Big chance here for Fredonia. Watch out for Charlie Manley's bomb of a clapper. He had 2 goals in last week's game against Buff State.
Victor Tracy comes in over the line now. Back to Cork on Barley. Over to Manley. Now to Tracy. Back out to Manley. He's at the point. Thought about that shot. Now gives it to Cork on Barley. Now Lee has it. Cork on Barley. Back out to Manley. Now to Tracy. He'll try a slap shot. Just a little high again. Manley to Tracy. Snipes this one, and nice save. And we're going to have a push out in front of the net. Middleton just threw down number 16 for Fredonia, Greg Lee, but no penalty.
Yeah, that's the sort of stuff you expect in front of the net on the power play, special teams, PK, whatever it is. Depends on what side you are. Nice little shove in front of the net, and Lee went down.
So this power line stays out there for Fredonia. It'll be Lee, Cork on Barley, Tracy, Manley, and Haynes. Fredonia wins a draw. Out to Manley at the point. This is where he's most dangerous. But his pass gets stolen away, and here comes Young. 1-on-3 now. Hale comes up with it. Oh, right off the post. Clanked that one right off the post, and now here comes Lee. Back to Cork on Barley. Out to Manley, but that one gets stolen by Young again. Manley's trying to catch up. Here comes Young. His shot saved by Rosen. Young gets it in the corner. Out to Pizzo. He drills it in behind Rosen. 39 seconds left on this penalty. Manley behind his own net. As his teammates change lines here. Now he gives it up to Whitman, to Dunner. He gets checked hard into the boards. And that puck trickles back out to the Fredonia zone. And Kuhn steals it for the Cardinals. Now gets it out to Arroyo. His shot gets deflected from Gamache. Only 7 seconds left here in this penalty. Ryder has that at center ice. 2-on-1 here for Fredonia. Ryder. I don't know where he was going there. He passed behind him and no one was there. And now the Cardinals have it at center ice. They get it in over the line. But they turn it over to Fredonia. Dunner tries flipping it in, and the Cardinals catch it and set it back down. Here's Middleton. He falls down, no tripping. And now a little 2-on-1 here. Shot wide of the net.
No, they called it.
Oh, it is, okay.
They called a tripping on a stick that was not in the hands of the Fredonia player. I have never seen that call ever been made.
Yeah,
looks,
I didn't.
Looks like Lemansky's got the penalty against him. It was Middleton who was coming down with the puck. Middleton made a move around Lemansky, and Lemansky's stick came out of his hands as Middleton went by, stayed on the ice, the stick, and Middleton stepped on the stick to fall down, and they called that a tripping. Yikes.
So the fourth power play here for the Cardinals as the Blue Devils steal it away. Dimakopoulos gives it up to Haynes, and he shoots just a little high. Actually, I believe that was saved, and then it got deflected a little high. So good chance there for Fredonia. Haynes all over number 23 for Plattsburgh. That was Christian DeFelice. Now Anselmo gives it up to McCartney. He swings it in behind Rosen. McCabe's there to steal it back. And he will sling it back down the ice, preventing the Cardinals from scoring on that attack at least. 10:23 left in the period. Minute 15 left in the power play. Cardinals come in over the line. Arroyo, his shot gets deflected. Hale gets it. Now into the corner. Back out to Arroyo. He has it at the point. Puts on a shot and saved. And we're going to have some pushing in front of the net with McCabe and Hale. I believe that is the second or third time Hale's been involved down low.
Yeah, well, he's definitely paying the price in front. The way his head flung back, it looked like he got stuck in the face. But he's wearing a full cage, so I'm not sure what the head jerk's about. But then he liked to shove McCabe a couple of times. McCabe didn't go anywhere. Big, tough guy.
Trying to flop a little for the call?
Yeah. You know, I would never insinuate something like that, but yeah, definitely.
Ryder now on the draw for Fredonia. 57 seconds left in this power play for Plattsburgh. Ryder wins a draw, and Gamash sends it down the ice. Cardinals will regroup here with Pizzo. Now to Hale. Cross ice pass, and now Hale gets it back right in front of the net. He can't hang on. Comes out to Draven. 30 seconds left on this penalty here. Pizzo gets around Demakopoulos. Now shot by Draven, goes a little wide of the net. Now out to Tredowitz. He fans on that shot. Pizzo, 17 seconds left. Now down on the wing, shot wide by Thomas. Pizzo from the point, saved by Rosen. 7 seconds left. Thomas to Draven. Back out to the point with Pizzo. Nice move around his defender. Tredowitz off the post as the penalty to Tracy expires. Or was that Lemanski? Oh. And this shot gets deflected out of play. So Fredonia very lucky there, as that one was inches away from being a tie game.
Yeah, Rosen's might need to buy a present to that post, because that left post has been his friend tonight.
Now, I didn't even realize, was Tracy coming off of the bench or the penalty box?
I think Tracy went to the bench, and his replacement was going into the zone as that puck went off the post. So and then they called someone in the crease, and that's why the faceoff came outside the zone.
It was Lemanski with the penalty, though, right?
Oh, right. It's okay, Lemanski. Okay. Yeah.
So it was Lemanski. So, yeah, Tracy, that wasn't Tracy. We're going to have another stoppage of play here.
They're both like 6'4", you know, easy getting confused.
And it is pizza time, as I could use some pizza up here.
That'd be amazing. Can we get delivery?
Now Tracy has it, works along the boards here. He's down in the corner. Music's still playing as the play goes on here. Like an NBA game, music during the game. Except NBA, it's music every 2 seconds.
Yeah, we're just trying to, you know, branch out and draw some more fans in. If you hear now, those cheers, that's people shouting for the pizza as the puck gets skied over the mesh. And faceoff's going to be to the left of Rosen in the defensive zone for Fredonia.
8:18 left. And the pizza has a home.
And if you ever want to see joy, look at this man's face who's about to get a free pizza. That is a 5-year-old getting a bike on Christmas Eve.
I was going to say, he's like a little kid on Christmas right now. Puck goes out to Pizzo. And McCabe battles for it down in the corner. Gets it out. And just a little too far for Kalou. So Pizzo will have it behind his own net now. Trying to set something up here. Up to Anselmo. He'll get it in behind the net behind Rosen. Lee now. Blitz plays it along the boards. Puck pops up. And DeFelice has it now in the corner. Nice pass out to number 10, Falanja. And that one gets deflected right by the penalty box here. Lee falls down, battle for the puck, and I believe that was Lee who sent that in. Pareda gives it up to DeFelice now. He's in over the line. Shot. Kicked aside from Rosen. Puck comes out to center ice. Cardinals bring it in over the line once again. Here's Thomas. Good defense from Tommy Martin. Forces them to bring it back out to the point now. Stolen by Whitman. And the Cardinals fire it right back in. Under 7 minutes to go here. 1-0, Fredonia. McCabe finishes his check. Puck comes out and gets deflected in the corner. Back out to the point. Here's Middleton. Backhands it into the corner. Now Demikopoulos. He'll flip it in. And Pareda will cover up and gets it out to center ice with Lawson now. He'll put on the brakes. Nice little move around Kalou. And Dahl battling for it. Gets it down low. Another battle in the corner. Kalou's there for Fredonia. Sutton. Shot on. Saved by Rosen. And now Ryder. In the neutral zone. Swings it in. Pareda plays it behind the net once again. Hale up to Tredowitz. And pad save there from Rosen. 5.5 to go here in the second period. Ryder into Letmanski. Tries to center it, but no one's there. But Johnson now saves it. Cork on Barley. Shot it wide of the net. Puck comes out to Johnson. Now Haynes will put the shot up. Saved by Pareda. Sutton at center ice. Stolen by Tracy. Finds Haynes. He's in all alone. And he scores! Jacob Haynes buries home his team leading 11th goal of the year. And the Blue Devils have a 2-0 lead.
You know, third time's a charm here for Haynesy. He got his third breakaway of the night. And this one he buries over the blocker of Prado. And excellent shot there by Haynes. Way to blow past the defenseman, break it into the zone, and great pass by, I think it was Tracy, to spring him on that. Great neutral zone play that turned into offense. That's the kind of transition play that'll be key for Fredonia in extending this lead.
Yeah, Tracy and Haynes, they've been playing well tonight, but, you know, like you said a couple times, Haynes came in, and that was his third breakaway, and Pareda made the save on the first two, but like you said, third time's a charm. So Fredonia has a 2-0 lead here with under 5 to go. Ryan Dunner now up to Lee at center ice. He comes in over the line, gives it to Dunner. Stolen away by Pizzo. Now Young in over the line. Back to Pizzo. Shot saved by Rosen. And the Blue Devils come back in over the line with Lee. His shot saved by Pareda. Demikopoulos goes after it. Blitz all alone and blocked by Young, actually, as Pareda was just making his way back into the net. On Demikopoulos. Nice pass over to Manley. His shot tried sniping one in that top corner, but Pareda is there to snag it out of midair.
Yeah, Fredonia definitely using the momentum gained from that goal by Haynes. And they are just pouring it on these Plattsburgh Cardinals. It is awesome to watch, and hopefully they can continue it, because, you know, we're totally objective.
Well, shots are now 20-17 in favor of Plattsburgh, and obviously Fredonia has put two of those in the back of the net. As Ryder, gets hit hard into the boards, and yeah, we're going to have a penalty here. That was a shot to the head, actually.
Yeah, but looks like they're calling interference. Ryder tipped it by the defenseman to try and dump and chase, and the defenseman did not want to turn around, so he just hit Ryder right in front of the Fredonia bench. They were not happy, but I'm sure they're not complaining now that they've got a power play to work with.
So Matt Arroyo will be in the box. He is their third leading scorer. So Fredonia back on the power play here. Tracy to the point with Manley. Cork on Barley, back to Manley. He'll put the shot on just a little high. Tracy with the rebound. Tracy still has it. Back out to Manley. He'll wind up. Shot gets deflected. Haynes.
Yeah, Kuhn blocked that one, and it looked like it hurt.
Haynes tries centering it to Cork on Barley. And now to Tracy. Shot trickles wide. Cork on Barley now. To Manley at the point. This is where, again, he's most dangerous. Especially on the power play here. Now Tracy. His pass a little too far for Haynes. And Manley's there to recover. A minute left in the penalty. Blue Devils work it down low with Haynes. Nice move around his defender. Shot and a real nice kick save there from Prada, but he was not able to cover up as the Cardinals get it out to center ice. And I believe that hit Tyler Ryder as he was coming back onto the ice. Just a little too far.
Yeah, kind of a confusing play there. Had a couple of Blue Devils coming off. I don't think they're calling too many men because they definitely didn't have more than five guys on the ice, but the puck hit the linesman and they blew it dead. Kind of an odd play there, but we have a faceoff outside the zone.
Oh, so it hit the linesman. I thought that hit Ryder.
I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure the Zebra got hit.
Well, the Cardinals send it back down to Rosen where he will play it. Gives it to Gamache. 30 seconds left in this one-man advantage. Gamache, nice pass up to Dunner. Shot wide of the net. Gamache chases after it. Now behind the net, Ryan Dunner goes after it. Back out to Tommy Martin. Swings it over to Gamache. Back to Martin. 10 seconds left on the penalty. Now Whitman on the wing to Gamache. Dunner. This is Martin out to Gamache. And he scores! Just as the penalty ended, Hugo Gamache buries one home, and it's 3-0 Fredonia.
Yeah, that whole play starts from a good pass from down low and a great screen in front by Ryder.
So just like that, Fredonia has a 3-0 lead here with a minute and 50 seconds left in this second period.
Yeah, Ryder was the one who drew the original penalty and he was instrumental in blocking Paredo's vision. Paredo.
So Fredonia has, each team has 20 shots on goal now. The difference is Fredonia has found the back of the net three times.
Only shots that matter are the ones that go in the back of the net, and Fredonia's got three.
So 3-0 here with under two to play. Tredowitz has that one poked away. Now Lutmanski tries to play it up to Demikopoulos a little too far as the Cardinals recover here. This is Arroyo. Swings it over to Middleton. Middleton still has it. And that shot is saved by Rosen. Where's the puck? There it is. Haynes plays it along the boards.
And we got a penalty behind the play. Fredoni's going on another power play.
So with 1 minute and 1 second left in this second period, Fredonia will be on the one-man advantage again here as let's see who's going to take this one. Tredowitz.
Yeah, it was an excellent form tackle behind the net, but wrong sport, but... So we have another power play for Fredonia as they get their top unit out there of Haynes, Manley, Cork and Barley, Lee, and Tracy. Watch them to try and get it to Manley. He's already hurt one Plattsburgh player with his shot.
Manley over to Tracy. Down low into Haynes. Now Lee. Cork on Barley. Back behind the net with Haynes. Now Lee behind the net. 40 seconds left in the period. Haynes out to Tracy. Back to Haynes. To Cork on Barley. Now to Haynes. Now Tracy. His shot gets deflected wide of the net. And Lawson will send it back down with 20 seconds left as Rosen plays it behind the net. maybe one last push here for Fredonia. As Manley gets it up to Ryan Dunner now. 10 seconds left. Dunner gets checked into the boards. Puck will go into the corner. 5 seconds left. Still a fight, and that should do it for the second period here as the buzzer sounds. And Fredonia has a 3-0 lead going into the third period.
Yeah, very good period there by the Fredonia Blue Devils. Couple lucky bounces with the Plattsburgh shots going off the post, but Fredonia making no mistake with a nice point shot by Gamache to go post and in, and the breakaway goal by Haynes. Excellent job by the Blue Devils to take that lead and not give anything back.
So Haynes gets his team-leading 11th goal of the year. And, yeah, Fredonia with a very nice period. Outshot Plattsburgh. Let's see. Shots were 9-7. So just some quick math here. 15-12 that period. And, yeah, they will go into the period up 3 goals. So with that, we will take a quick break, and then Trevor will be back on to do the intermission report. I got to throw some pucks here. Chuck-a-puck time. So see you in a few.
Good luck to you. back, everyone, to your second intermission report. You're listening to Hockey Night in Fredonia on WDVL 89.5, The Inferno, and WCBF 88.9, The Voice. I am Steve Stavursky, and with me is...
I'm Trevor Hauer.
And we got a very exciting period that we just came from your Fredonia Blue Devils. They took a 3-0 lead in that period from a breakaway goal from Jacob Haynes and a point shot on the power play from Gamache that went top corner. What'd you see, Trev?
I could not choose which goal was nicer. I mean, both of them were great. The one on the breakaway was a snipe right over the shoulder, and same with the one from the point. He took a shot, wrist shot, went right over the shoulder, top shelf. It was a great shot.
Yeah, especially Gamache's shot, because, you know, on a breakaway, you do have some options, but Gamache had to get it through at least 4 people on the way to the net, and he was able to feed it through and get it posted in.
He was
a
very,
beautiful
very,
goal. As a defenseman, I like that one better.
Yes, that was very, very precise. He put it right where it needed to be, put him up by 3. But this game, we all know the game of hockey. It's not over yet.
Oh, absolutely not. And your Blue Devils proved it last week when they were down 3 goals under 5 minutes to play. Against Buff State. And they turned a breakaway goal, shocker, from Jacob Haynes, and a power play coming off of that breakaway goal into a 3-goal, 5-minute to end the period.
And definitely the 5-5 tie is a way better result rather than a possible 5-2 loss last week. But they did climb out of the hole. They did come up with a tie, and that's what's keeping them alive in these standings.
Yeah, and with the score being 3-0 for Fredonia, we're hoping not to see any last-minute heroics necessary here. Rosen's playing a solid game in net. He is getting
very
an assist
solid
by his left post. He's made that post has done a number for him. One slid right by him, and it clanged off the post off a power play, and then another one off a 2-on-1. So getting a little lucky, but Rosen is playing a solid game. He's staying in position. He's not giving up too many dangerous rebound chances, and the Fredonia defense is clearing out any opportunities.
And for what I've noticed so far is Adam Tredowitz, the player number 21 for Plattsburgh, this dude is always trying to snipe, but he ended up hitting the post once. Good thing for Fredonia is that he's in the box for another minute at the start of this period, because he's been picking the corners. He's just come up short on a couple good shots. But credit to Rosen, too. He's been holding his ground, and, you know, you can't win games without solid goaltending.
Yeah, another night in college hockey and another game determined by special teams. Fredonia's got a power play goal, and they've been able to kill off every opportunity that Plattsburgh has had. They took another couple penalties that period, but they stayed mostly 5-on-5, or they were up due to Plattsburgh infractions, which is great to see, and they were able to sustain a bunch of pressure in the offensive zone.
If Plattsburgh wants to come back and win this game, they need to turn this number around. The 0-for-4 on the power play, they've had a total of 11 minutes on the power play. That's half of an entire period. If you can't score there, I'm not really sure what to tell you here.
Yeah, the frustration's got to be mounting in that locker room as their coach tries to refocus their team. 3-0 is by no means an insurmountable lead.
Absolutely not.
They got to get one to get started, and hopefully Fredonia is able to buckle down and not give up any chances. But they would be very unwise to sit back on this lead. They need to keep attacking, keep possessing the puck down low, and most importantly, stay 5-on-5.
Absolutely.
Use your feet, not your stick, and keep your arms down.
And dig. Dig for the puck as much as you can. Set up chances, get pucks in deep, and you know, get some more insurance goals here. Let's go up 4-0, and then let's bring it up to 5-0, hopefully.
Yeah, get the fans a show. We're all here. It's cold outside. We had a winter storm all day.
Oh, freezing cold.
Had to brush off our cars like 4 times just to get to class, you know. But we're here.
We're in it.
We're here supporting our team. And, you know, I'd like to see a nice crooked number on that screen for our team.
That's what I'd like to see, too.
It'd be fantastic.
Snow or shine, we will show up here and just announce the game for you, because we are just so loyal to this team.
Hey, it's hockey. We love hockey, and they're playing very well, and it's great to see.
Nothing like a Friday night in Fredonia watching hockey.
Yeah, the goaltending stats so far, Anton Rosen has, in his return, has turned away all 21 shots against him for
Very
21
good.
Saves. Meanwhile, Jimmy Pareda for Plattsburgh has given up 3 goals on 22 shots. So he's got 19 saves. And Pareda has made some excellent saves, especially on some of those power
Absolutely.
Plays. There was one rebound that I remember came out to the side, and Lee tried to stuff it home, and he went, he got his pad down and
slammed the glove right on it, covered
yep.
it up, and the whistle went. He's been standing his ground as much as he can. You can just only hope for him that his defense might step up for him this period.
Yeah, I mean, when the leading scorer of an opposing team gets 3 breakaways, one of them's eventually going to go in.
Yeah.
And third time was the charm for Jacob Haynes with his team-leading 11th goal of the season for his also team-leading 26th point of the season. He's having quite a senior year, and it's awesome to see. Hopefully
Jacob,
he can keep it up. He is a leader on this team, and he's doing an excellent job.
Absolutely. Jacob Haynes is a lethal weapon to any team here in the SUNYAC, and to be able to contain him, they need to get a lot of work done because they're already down by 3. They got 20 minutes to play.
All right, we're going to take a quick break. This has been your second intermission report with Steve and Trev. We'll be back for your quick post game with hopefully a Fredonia dub, knock on wood.
Hopefully a big W.
Yeah, you've been listening to Hockey Night in Fredonia, WDVL 89.5 The Inferno, and WCVF 88.9 The Voice. Take a quick break, and we'll see you on the other side for the start of the period.
Trouble with me, trying to keep it peaceful is a struggle for me. Don't pull up at 6 a.m. to cuddle with me. You know how I like it when you loving on me. I don't wanna die for them to miss me. Yes, I see the things that they wishing on me. Hope I got some brothers that outlive me. They gon' tell the story was different with me. God's plan, God's plan. I hold back sometimes, I won't. Yeah. I feel good sometimes I don't, like, no. I finesse down Western Road, like, yes. Might go down to G-O-D, yeah, wait. I go hard on Southside G, yeah, wait. I make sure that Northside E. And still, bad things, it's
It's a lot of bad things that they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish on me.
Bad things. Back here in Steel Hall as we are 50 seconds away from the start of the third period, as Fredonia once again has a 3-0 lead over the Plattsburgh Cardinals. Now taking a look at the SUNYAC standings here, Fredonia is in dead last, but they are not, they don't play as bad as their record shows. They've been in pretty much just about every game this year. And, you know, they're 6 points out of the playoffs now, Steve, but that could easily, they could have easily been in the 3 or 4 seed now if, you know, a couple of those games went the opposite way.
Oh, absolutely. Other than maybe 1 or 2 games, all season it's been one goal games, either wins, loss, or tie. It is within one goal. So this team, they've been on the short end of some very tight games. But right now they got a 3-0 lead as they line up for start this third period. And hopefully they're able to take it to this Plattsburgh team. Don't sit back. Take it to them. And let's play some hockey.
So Plattsburgh is right above Fredonia in the standings. They have 8 points. We have 4. And they are 6-11-3 overall. 3-6-2 in the conference, and then once again Fredonia is 4-9-6 overall and 1-7-2 in SUNYAC play. So the Blue Devils will still be on the man advantage here as the Cardinals get it behind Rosen. Manley chips it up the boards. Haynes, 30 seconds left. Haynes leaves it for Manley. Now up to Cork on Barley. Lee chases after it. Manley saves it to Tracy. Down low to Haynes, puts up the shot. Saved by Pareda.
Yeah, good keep in there by Manley, getting over to Tracy. Tracy moving down low to Haynes, and he makes no mistake. His first step is towards the net, which is an excellent job on the power play. Able to get a pretty good chance trying to go short side on Pareda.
11 seconds left here on the penalty. Fredonia wins the draw. Ryder slings it over to Blitz. His slap shot is saved by Pareda, and that will do it for the penalty. Cardinals come up with Draben now. His shot gets blocked by McCabe, stolen by Ryder. Ryder in over the line, down low by the net, tries to center that, now it comes out to Blitz. Blitz keeps it in, but can't keep it in on the second attempt, so he will just fire it down into the corner. Pizzo. Going through the Fredonia defense here, still has it down in the corner. Now out to Draben. Shot wide of the net. Excuse me, that was Dull. Judd uses the boards to dump it down low. Now Demakopoulos goes after it. Comes right back to Judd. And now the Cardinals send it down behind Rosen for an icing.
Yeah, hard hit there on Judd, but he didn't go down, and the Plattsburgh player who hit him actually did. Well, that's what happens when you hit the big man, Judd. He's what, 6'4"?
6'3", 220.
Okay, he's only 6'3".
And then Anders Johnson, he's 6'5", 230.
Yikes.
And he's only a freshman, so.
Yeah, maybe he hasn't hit his growth spurt yet.
Yeah, maybe by the time he's a senior, he'll be 7 foot.
Yeah, you'll be calling him on the basketball games.
Oh, Lee gets stood up here by DeFelice. Big hit there from the Cardinals. And now McCartney has that one poked away. Battle behind the net. Martin comes away and flips it into the neutral zone, but now it goes into the Cardinals zone, and Lee with a nice backhand shot. Pareda with the save. Now the Cardinals come in, and shot is saved by Rosen. Arroyo gets it. Skates back out to the point. Now leaves it for Middleton. And Haynes is able to poke that one away. And now he's in one on two here.
Oh!
And a big check, and Haynes is down.
That was a hit directly to his chin. That's got to be more than two if they called 5 minutes earlier. Yikes.
He's still down as he's getting up now. So a hard hit there from number 18, Matt Arroyo.
Haynes is back on his feet and heading towards the bench. Definitely going to get checked out by the trainer there. That was a vicious hit directly to his head. Hopefully he's all right. Those are the kind of dangerous plays you don't want to see in this game, and the refs are talking about it in front of the penalty box. We'll see what this comes out to. Right now, Aurelio is sitting in the box, which would mean it's a two-minute, but they're talking to Martin and Middleton. We'll see. Oh, it looks like they are going to send him off.
Yeah,
it is a five-minute major for contact to the head.
So a game misconduct. That's what Ethan Kerbis had in the first period. And now Matt Arroyo gets it in the third period here.
Yeah, got a couple of fans waving to him as he leaves. You know, just trying to be polite.
Now, I don't remember what game it was last year, but something happened where there was, you know, a big play, a big scrap, and I believe someone got ejected, and the crowd really started heckling him as he came off the ice. And I think he said something to the crowd, and I can't remember. Oh, you know what it was? It was the fans from their team started yelling at our fans.
Oh, fun.
And it was like a full-out battle here,
yep.
A verbal battle.
Yeah, starting out this five-minute power play. We got a shot on net. Ryder fights for it. But Plattsburgh recovers.
And now Kuhn has it at center ice. And the Cardinals still have it here. Lawson leaves it for Kuhn. But Tommy Martin's able to recover. Gamache now. Up to Tracy, and that one is going to be offsides.
Yep, the Plattsburgh player got their stick in, deflected. It slowed it enough to mess up the Fredonia player's timing. That was Ryder breaking into the zone. Just a hair offside. Still 4:27 left on this power play. They really need to take advantage of this. They don't want to be like Plattsburgh was in the first period, where they come out of it getting frustrated with a failed power play and giving all the momentum back to them.
So the Blue Devils win the draw. And they have their big line out now. Manley has it. Brings it in over the line. Fires it back around the boards. The Cardinals are able to recover and send it right back down.
Yeah, Haynes is out here for this power play. Great to see him back on the ice.
Cork on Barley. Steals it back from the Cardinals. Devils will try to regroup here. Manley up to Haynes. That one gets poked away and sent right back down. Rosen plays it behind the net, gives it to Manley. This line will try one more time. Haynes flips it in, chases after. Pareda's way out to play that. Cork on Barley now. Back to Manley. Tracy, down low to Haynes. A little too far for him. But he's still able to get the puck. Now Manley. Tracy. No good. And that was Jasper Cork on Barley with the rebound. And he scores his second goal of the night to give Fredonia a 4-0 lead.
Yeah, Cork on Barley really loves him some rebounds tonight. He's got two goals off of him, the first one and the fourth one. It was great puck movement from Haynes to Manley to Tracy with the one-timer. And Pareda was down and out by the time Cork and Barley collected it and buried it into the open net.
So Fredonia will stay with the man advantage here. 3:11 left in the five-minute major. So 4-0 is the score. They win the draw here. Gamache, he has a goal tonight. He brings it in over the line. But that one gets poked away by Kuhn, and it will come all the way over to Rosen. Now it comes out to center ice, where Fredonia will just send it into the corner. Ryan Dunner chases after it. Middleton up to number 39. Liam Lawson back to Middleton. Stolen by Gamache. 2.5 left in the major. Pizzo has it at center ice. As the Cardinals are able to just flip this one back behind the Fredonia net. And Steve, was that Arroyo that just walked behind us? I think that might have been him.
Nah, that would have been way too fast.
It looked like it could have been him. Now Haynes comes in, shot just wide. Now Cork on Barley with 2 goals tonight. One away from the hat trick. Tracy. Fight for it. Now Haynes puts on the brakes. Out to Manley. Cork on Barley. Saved by Pareda. 1.5 left. Manley. Nice move, but...
Whoa.
And we're going to have another penalty here.
Yup, the Plattsburgh player lost his stick, so when Manley walked around him, he grabbed him to try and slow him down.
Oh, go ahead.
And Fredonia is going to go on to a 5-on-3 with a full 1:29 left on the first penalty. A lot of time and space. Let's see if they utilize it.
Wow. So 5-on-3 for 1.5 minutes. That was on Mitchell Hale. Fredonia wins the draw. Here's Manley. To Tracy. Down low to Haynes. Has it in the corner. But Middleton steals it, and now he comes in, puts up the shot. Shoulder save from Rosen. Cork on Barley starts it off for the Blue Devils. Now Tracy. No need to rush here for Fredonia. Trying to set something up, Manley. Down low to Haynes. Shot. Goes high and over the net and into the net. Into the mesh.
Yeah, just missed the top corner there. Haynes trying to go top shatter for his second goal of the game. And the second unit comes out. Looks like Ryder's going to take this draw. Still a 5-on-3 for 49 seconds.
So it'll be Ryder, Whitman, Dunner, Gamache, and Martin. Cardinals win the draw and are able to squeeze it out over the Blue Devils, the line, and Gamache goes back to recover. Now Dunner comes in with speed. Back to Ryder. Martin, Gamache at the point. Nice pass to Ryder. Can't finish there. Now Whitman to Gamache. Over to Martin. He'll wind up. And he scores! Tommy Martin with the slap shot. It's 5-0.
Captain Clutch with a bomb from the point. Gets it through the defender who was looking to block it. And on the 5-on-3, Fredonia scores to make it 5-0.
So the penalty to Mitchell Hale has expired, but the major is still being served for another 17 seconds. So 5-0 is the score here on Hockey Night in Fredonia.
Yeah, Blue Devils definitely bringing out all their scores tonight. Love to see it. Only 17 seconds left on the major.
So let's see. Let's get caught up here. Jasper Cork on Barley has 2. Hugo Gamache has 1. Jacob Haynes has 1. And now Tommy Martin with the 5th goal. Pareda plays this one behind the net. Tracy, the major has expired, so Fredonia gets 2 goals on that. Lee out to Manley. Back to Lee. Fredonia still controlling the puck here. Haynes puts up the shot. Saved by Pareda. Pizzo behind the net. He'll start things off for Plattsburgh. 11.5 to go. That one's drilled in off of McCabe, though. And now Young tries a shot. Goes wide of the net and out to center ice, where Anselmo spins around and tries to get things started now. but they turn it over. Here's Ledmanski. Slides that one in. Ryder recovers. Out to McCabe, and he can save it. Good try there. So he'll just send it back down behind Pareda. This is number 12 now for the Cardinals, Christian Dahl. Now up to Thomas. Gets stripped from Max Blitz. Good defense there. And now Chandler Judd. Nice pass to Demakopoulos. Deflected just a little wide of the net. Kuhn in over the line. Puts it into the corner. Tommy Martin's there. He'll flip it up and into center ice.
I'm calling high stick. They're saying the Plattsburgh player took it out of the air with a high stick, so the puck, the faceoff is going to come all the way down into the Plattsburgh end to Pareda's right.
Now, what's the rule with that for high sticking? When do they?
Your shoulder. Stick can't be above your shoulder when you play it.
So how come that wasn't a penalty? Was that?
So it's only a high sticking penalty when you hit someone in the face.
Oh, okay. So you, okay, yeah.
If you just hit the puck, it just stops the play dead and it goes into your defensive zone.
Because I've seen like high sticking before, then, you know, what just happened, there's no penalty. I'm
yep.
like, wasn't that a high sticking? But okay, so
yep, there's
only
the
if they
high
hits
sticking
another player.
That stops it, and then there's high sticking penalty where someone gets hit in the face.
Shot
you don't
want to
get hit in the face.
Gets blocked, and Kalu comes in and has that one stripped. Now, Falanja. Nice pass into the slot, but stolen. Sutton bats that one back down. Now gives it to Falanga. Shot, blocker save from Rosen. Puck is in the corner now, and Selmo. Or excuse me, that was DeFelice to Middleton. He'll put a shot and gets blocked with some traffic in front of the net. Hard hit there. Greg Lee was the victim there. Flipped into the corner. Anders Johnson gets it for Fredonia. Gamache. Up to Cork on Barley. Skates in. Flips it in behind the net. Tracy's there. And now a centering pass. No one's there for Fredonia. And the Cardinals, Schulte and Anselmo ran into each other, but Schulte comes away with it.
I wonder if they know they're on the same team.
And we're going to have an icing here.
Yeah, it is just not Plattsburgh's night. They've had a couple of good chances, but Fredoni's been able to shut them down. Nothing too dangerous recently. They did have some time in zone, but no hard shots, and Rosen has been solid, making every save he's been asked to make so far.
And here's some surprising news. Sabres are up 2-0, I just saw.
Gotta love it.
Sam Reinhart with the revenge game from his lazy play last night. I got to ask, what do you think about that?
End of his shift, end of the period, Ristolainen's got to make a better play.
So you're putting the blame on Ristolainen there?
I'm putting the blame on the whole team. They look like they did not look good last night. But you know who does look good? These Blue Devils as they break it out of their zone.
Now the Cardinals get it. And Kane has it. Puck is still in the neutral zone. Hale will send it back down behind Pareda. Hale. Up to McCartney. Now Draben, his shot gets blocked by Max Blitz. And Blitz will send it back around the boards where Hale has it. Fight in the corner. Comes back out. Now behind the net with Hale. Put on the brakes. Has that one stripped as another stick has flown. That was, whose stick was that? Oh, Whitman.
McCabe lost his stick. Whitman gave him his.
And now the Cardinals have it here with Tredowitz. Gives it over to Draben, in over the line. Nice little move there. Draben still has it. His shot. Stopped by Rosen. Rebound comes out, and the Blue Devils send it back down the ice. Rosen's still down. Now he gets up. Pizzo with Lee on him. Works it in, but Kalu is there to prevent any momentum. But Lawson recovers, puts up the shot, now blocked by Kalu. It's a good shift there from Tanner Kalu. Devils send it back down. And we're going to have an icing.
Barely made it for icing there. But it is going to be an icing and a defensive draw for Fredonia. Nope. Not able to make changes, but this draw is going to be huge. If Plattsburgh gets possession, they got some tired Blue Devils out there. Hopefully they aren't able to take advantage. All comes down to Kalu here at the draw.
Kalu loses a draw. Shot trickles in front of the net, but Martin's there to steal it. Now up to Lee, in over the line. Greg Lee tries to center it. Good look there, but no one was there. Cardinals have it at center ice. Here's Kuhn. He'll leave it for Thomas. Now Anselmo. Chest save from Rosen, and he covers up.
Yeah, no rebound there, which is key. You don't want to be giving Plattsburgh any momentum, even if there's only 6:11 left in this period and the game. You don't want them getting any whiff of a goal.
You know, Rosen's been... He's played a real solid game in his first game back in action after suffering multiple concussions this year. 27 saves now for the senior.
Yeah, he did not forget how to stop the puck.
And meanwhile, on the other hand, 27 saves for Pareda. The difference is 5 have gone in. So 32 shots to 27 in favor of Fredonia. Ooh. Tracy dancing around his defenders. Gives it over to Haynes. Swings it back along the boards behind the net. Cardinals recover. Now get it up to McCartney. But Blue Devils send it right back down. Here's Cork on Barley now. He has it behind the net. And nice pass out to McCabe. His shot just a little wide. Now Haynes has it behind the net. Centering pass to Cork on Barley. Gets deflected away. Now Blitz winds up, shoots that one wide. Now Alden in over the line. Another save from Anton Rosen.
Yeah, making it look easy out there. Right into the glove, nonchalantly grabs it. Love to see it.
5:14 left. Once again, you're listening to Kevin Syracuse and Steve Stiversky on Fredonia Radio. It's Hockey Night in Fredonia. And a reminder, tomorrow, a huge game. Hockey-wise and for other reasons, obviously, as it is Pink the Rink night. So if you can make it out, as much as we like that you guys listen to us, if you can make it here, that would be great.
The breast cancer awareness night.
Rosen's there to cover it up. So, yeah, Fredonia, assuming they hold on to the win here.
Knock on wood.
Good thing.
The theme of tonight.
So they will go to 2-7-2 in the conference, so they'll have 6 points. So if Morrisville loses tonight, they will be 4 games back with 5 to play. Or 4 points back with 5 games to play. So obviously every game is crucial here for Fredonia. Shot goes wide of the net, and the Blue Devils play it into center ice here. Chandler Judd, his dump-in gets deflected right way high above the Plattsburgh bench. The final countdown is playing here from the Pep Band. Yeah, tomorrow should be an awesome game between, you know, all the festivities, the breast cancer awareness, and obviously the hockey game itself.
Who's coming into town? Is it Potsdam?
Yeah, Potsdam. And they are right above Plattsburgh in the standings. So, obviously, you know, a huge game for playoff reasons and for, you know, good night for breast cancer awareness too. You know, the first night they did this, they made SportsCenter.
Wow.
I can't remember how many years ago. I want to say a dozen years ago.
SportsCenter at one time played hockey. I'm shocked.
Yeah, Fredonia made the top 10 plays.
You sure it wasn't SportsCenter like RE in Canada?
Yes.
That's the only time I've seen hockey on SportsCenter.
It was SportsCenter in LA or Connecticut, wherever.
Yeah, wherever. Went to Bristol, then LA, and then I stopped watching.
So I'm going to try to find what year of doing this it is.
All right, draw outside the Fredonia zone.
Wow, 14th straight year.
Wow.
So 14 years ago they made SportsCenter. I believe that's on YouTube.
Interesting. That was back when we actually liked SportsCenter because they played sports.
And that was the year when Sabres went to the Eastern Conference Finals.
Yeah, we like sports. We don't care who knows.
3:40 left to go here. Cardinals work it in. Lawson puts a shot up, and where's the puck? There it is. Rosen's there for the cover-up. He's there again. Fight behind the net for the puck. A couple of nice saves there from Anton Rosen. Cardinals putting on the pressure. Shot gets blocked, and Manley drills that one out and down behind. Oh, okay, I didn't even realize this.
Yeah, it's going to be an icing, but Rosen had lost his stick. The defenseman had given him his, so at least they're able to, they might not be able to change, but they can at least get their sticks in their hands.
Well, what I was going to
say, also a plus.
What I was going to say that I didn't notice, we have a new netminder.
Oh, we do.
Number 34, Brandon Wells, the sophomore from Alberta, is in for Pareda now. Fredonia will take a timeout here.
I mean, you got one. They're playing for their goaltender, and really glad Coach Meredith's letting his guys rest so they can finish this one out strong. Rosen's played an excellent game, and he deserves to have his team play well in front of him to finish this one out.
So now shots, 32-31 for Fredonia. So 31 saves for Rosen in his first game back in action. Fredonia's 2-for-5 on the power play. Plattsburgh 0-for-4. And faceoffs, Fredonia has 31 wins, Plattsburgh 25. Once again, the Blue Devils are up 5-0 here with just over 3 to play.
Yep, faceoff's going to be to the left of Rosen here. It looks like Ryder's taking it.
And it will be Allen for Plattsburgh as he wins this. Slap shot from Anselmo goes wide and goes all the way back down behind the new netminder, Brandon Wells. Cardinals come up with speed with Falanga. Blitz gets it. Now back out to Pizzo. He flips it right back where Blitz gets it in the corner and slings it out to center ice. Flipped over to Pizzo. Now Alden. Shot gets deflected. That was off of the stick of Cullen Kane. Cork on Barley now as he is trying to get a hat trick maybe here. 2:20 left. Now the Cardinals come up, 3-on-3 here. Kane, stood up by Johnson. And now Whitman will, oh, he still has it here. I thought he dumped that one in.
He tried to, got a weird bounce off the glass.
So under 2 to go here.
Oh, and we got a penalty here. It's gonna be a hooking penalty on Demakopoulos. Right at center ice, he was trying to get possession, try and break up the offensive rush. Got in on the hands of the player, got the puck, and they deemed it was a penalty.
So Fredonia will be on the penalty kill for the rest of this game unless the Cardinals score. Should we knock on wood one last time?
It's been working.
Cardinals win the draw. Here's Middleton at the point. to Kane. Kane still has it on the wing here. Back out to Middleton. Sutton. Pass gets deflected right back to him. Now to Schulte. Downloaded Lawson. Young. Schulte. Shot. Deflects right on Rosen. He's there to save it. And the Blue Devils send it down the ice. Just over a minute left to go in this game. Middleton up to Hale. Now Haynes gets it and flips it right back down. Under a minute to go. Wells plays it behind the net. Now Hale back to Anselmo. Pizzo has that one stolen and flipped back behind the Plattsburgh net where they will set up. Try to get one last push here. Try to get on the scoreboard in the last 30 seconds. But Fredonia steals it, and we're going to have a fight here. Who is that, Max Blitz? And Brendan Young, it looks like. That happened in the background here, right in front of the Fredonia bench.
Oh.
Or who was that? Yeah, it was Max Blitz.
Max Blitz and 27.
Oh,
Hale.
That was Hale. He's been scrappy all night.
And the fans giving it to him right now.
And the refs are, one ref is holding Blitz and the other one's holding Hale. So Hale skates off.
They
and
are
he
not
slams the door.
They are not exchanging kind words. A lot of pointing, a lot of shouting. You know, I don't expect a group hug after this one.
So the refs discussing this one.
Yep, with 25 seconds left, we've got a little bit of a break here in the action. You know, overall, a very good game here for Fredonia. They took it to Plattsburgh start to finish. They were blessed with I wouldn't say blessed considering the Plattsburgh player hit Haynes right in the face to take a major penalty. Thank goodness Haynes is all right and he's been able to stay in this game. But they got a couple power play goals off of that to extend their lead.
Ten-minute misconduct. Not that that matters as there's 25 seconds left. Did something happen with Blitz when he came off the ice? Because I saw a bunch of the kids are standing over by the entrance right now, and Jerry Fisk went down there too.
Okay.
I thought he just skated off. Nothing happened, right?
No. He didn't look hurt. Did not appear to be happy, but did not appear to be hurt.
I mean, it's not like he would yell at the fans because we are the home team, so.
Nah. But, so it's 2 minutes for slashing, 2 minutes for roughing, and a 10-minute misconduct for each player. So with 25 seconds, it is unlikely they return to this game.
I think, yeah. I don't think they're returning. The kids were down there. They're talking to Ethan Kerbis now, the one who got the game misconduct in the first period. Puck comes out to Sutton. That one is kicked aside by Rosen. 8 seconds left. Can they preserve the shutout here?
You.
3, 2, 1. And they do. We didn't jinx them all night.
Oh, my goodness.
And Fredonia comes out of here with a 5-0 victory. Rosen gets a shutout in his first game back in action. And a big hug on Rosen around the net now.
Kevin, you see those zeros on the board? That's the only time you can say the word shutout.
I didn't say shutout.
You said it with 8 seconds left.
Brother
of two goaltenders. I have to scold you. It is in my nature. However, Fredonia does play an excellent game here against Plattsburgh. They do get a shutout for Rosen in his return. And get some momentum coming into Pink in the Rink, which is tomorrow night at 7 o'clock.
So once again, before I leave and Trevor comes back on, Fredonia wins 5-0 thanks to two goals from Cork on Barley, one from Gamache, one from Haynes, and one from Tommy Martin. 32 save shutout for Anton Rosen. And, yeah, just a great overall win for Fredonia. We'll be back in action tomorrow for the Pink the Rink game. I will be on color commentary, Josh Schmidt with the play-by-play. So thanks for tuning in. And here is Trevor once again.